Hello students, welcome to my online teaching session. In this session I'm going to start with English grammar syllabus. We'll start with the first chapter, and that is subject and predicate. Students, you have already learned about the basic structure of a sentence, so in this session we will just revise the basic structure and then we'll move on to the further topic, simple subject and predicate, compound subject and predicate, and how to find out a subject and predicate in a sentence, and kinds of sentence according to the structure. So first I'll start with the basic structure of a sentence. Now every sentence has a subject, which is usually a noun or a pronoun. It has a verb and an object or the complement of the sentence. It is not necessary that every sentence will have an object. And like you can see the examples, Maya ate an apple. Here ate is a verb. She writes well. The puppy sleeps in the basket. Now in this first sentence, Maya is the subject, ate is verb, and ate what? An apple. Apple is an object. She writes well. Writes is subject and well is an adverb. Okay, so that is a complement of the sentence. The puppy sleeps in the basket. Sleeps is the verb, the puppy is the subject, and in the basket is the object of the preposition, or you can say complement of the sentence. Now moving on, what is a subject? In a sentence, the person or the thing that performs the action is called the subject. In short, we can say that the doer of the action is the subject. The person who is doing the action is known as the subject. A subject can be a noun, pronoun, or a noun phrase. Okay? Now let's look at some of the examples. The boy looked happy. Who looked happy? The boy. The school is on the third street. Here, we are talking, the sentence is about the school. So the school is subject. They are extremely wealthy. So they is subject. Who are wealthy? They. The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. So here the fox, who? The fox jumped over the lazy dog. So the fox is subject. Swimming is my passion. What is my passion? Swimming. So swimming is the subject. Now, what is a predicate? Predicate, the rest part of the sentence is called as the predicate. So, predicate is the part of the sentence which has the verb. It also includes the verb, remember, and it tells what the subject is or what it does. So, a predicate can either be a simple word, one word, or it can be a more than one word of a verb phrase or any other modifier. Like I said that the bird sings. Now here you have a bird is subject, and as a predicate you have only one word, sings. So, but the sentence is complete, giving the complete meaning. So the bird sings or the birds fly. Fly, what does the bird do? It fly. So that is the predicate of the sentence. Or it can have they didn't get to the airport. So here they is subject and didn't get to the airport is the predicate. So remember student, predicate includes the verb and the rest part of the sentence. Now what are the parts of a predicate? A predicate can have an object, that is direct object, or the indirect object of the verb, which is mostly the person, and answers the question introduced by whom, and some sentences have no object. Now student, you can find out the direct object of the verb by asking the question what, like he ate an apple. Ate what? An apple. So an apple is the direct object. Okay, Indirect object is like he gave an apple to me. Gave what? An apple. So that is the direct object. And gave to whom? It is me. So me is indirect object. Okay, so this is the way to find out direct and indirect object in a sentence. So students, you know that every complete sentence contains two parts, a subject and a predicate. Now the subject is what or whom the sentence is about, and while the predicate tells something about the subject. Now there are two kinds of subject. One is known as the simple subject, or we call as the head verb, that is the main word in the subject, and a compound subject. Now what is a simple subject? Simple subject means when the subject is an individual, or means it is a single word or single person. Whereas what is a compound subject? When a sentence has more than one subject, that is more than one person is doing the action, then it is known as the compound subject. Like let's say the example, Ravi and Rohit read the same book. Now here, who is doing the action? Both Ravi and Rohit. So this is known as the compound subject. Neither Ram nor Rohit read the book. So here, both of them, Ram and Rohit, so have not read the book. So it is known as the compound subject. Both men and women enjoy doing yoga. Who enjoy doing yoga? Both men as well as women. So there are two doer of the action, so it is known as compound subject. Eating, sleeping and reading are enjoyable activities. What are enjoyable activities? It is more than two. It is eating, sleeping and reading. So these kind of sentence where there are the doer of the actions are more than one, it is known as compound subject. Now moving on to the next, what is a compound predicate? A compound predicate, similarly, a sentence that has more than one predicate, it is said to be a compound predicate. They are joined by a conjunction. Let's say the example, the kids climbed and jumped from the tree. Now here the work being done is two, climbing as well as jumping. Okay, so the kids climbed and jumped from the tree, and both the action is joined by the conjunction and, so it is known as compound predicate. Sunil visited Jammu and met his friend. So two actions are there, visited Jammu and met his friends. They again, both are predicates are joined by and, conjunction and. He ran, swam and rode a cycle in the resort. So here we have a compound predicate, ran, swam and rode a cycle in the resort. So a sentence that has more than one predicate is known as the compound predicate. So this is together, some sentence can have both compound subject and compound predicate. Compound subject and compound predicates are joined by either coordinating conjunction, mostly and, but, or, and, or correlative conjunction, either or, neither nor, both, also, etc. Let's see the example. Rita, Ria and Gia played guitar and sang songs. So here you can see the doer of the actions, playing the guitar, is three person, Rita, Ria and Gia. So that is a compound subject, and the action, what they did, they played the guitar, one action, and sang song, second actions. So you can see both this sentence has both compound subject as well as compound predicate. We had gone to the soccer game but had left at half time. Now here the doer of the action is one, we. It's a plural, but we have one subject here, we, but the predicates are two, that going to the soccer game and leaving at half time. So a sentence, there can be different kind of sentence. Some sentences may have simple subject and compound predicate. Some may have compound subject and single predicate. Some may have compound predicate as well as compound subject. So there are different ways to frame a sentence. Now, how to find a subject of a sentence? A simple way to find the subject is to ask who or what before the verb. Let's see the example. Junk foods are not good for you. Now, what is not good for you? Junk food. So, junk food is the subject. I eat junk food. Who eats? Verb is eat. So, who eats junk food? I. So, I here is the subject. So, that is the simple way, that who or what. Next is how to find out the predicate of the sentence. It can be found by asking what is the subject doing. For example, Ravi is writing an article. Now, what is Ravi doing? He is writing an article. So, is writing an article is a predicate. Like, as I said, birds fly. Okay, so what does the bird do? It flies. So fly is the predicate of the sentence. Okay, so that's all for today, students. I'm giving you two of the exercises. You can do this in your copy or on a sheet, and as well as you do the exercises that is given in your book. You can do those exercises in the book itself if there is a place, but the if blanks is there already. I think in exercise 1 and 2 you can do it in the book itself. Rest of the exercise I'll discuss in the next session. Thank you.